Welcome to the learning resource on setting up stationery and bookshop. In this presentation, we will cover technical details and some of the important points that needs to be considered for setting up stationery and bookshop. Stationery and bookshop is a very important venture, keeping in view the investment and the earnings returns expected from it. Now, firstly, you should know that what is stationery and bookshop, how the term stationery is defined. The term stationery refers to the writing and other office materials. A stationery and bookshop is a goods retail business mainly focusing on items such as pens, pencils, writing material, paper, colors, school supplies, office supplies, computer stationery, etc. There are various services that the owner of the stationery and bookshop gives to its customer, such as magazines, notebooks, chart papers, writing supplies, etc. The stationery and bookshop is an enterprise where owner sells stationery items and books to the customers. The stationery and bookshop also sells magazines for different age groups, magazines on different topics, all are available in the stationery and bookshop. For example, magazines for housewives, senior citizens, magazines for kids, competition magazines, etc. This business involves keeping the inventory of the books, stationery items for the purpose of sale. As you see in the photograph, the different goods, the different books, the different stationery items are stored on the racks. The inventory is kept by the owner of the shop and then it is sold to the customer. The stationery and bookshop retailers provide goods and supplies you and I need every day. There are many facets of this exciting business. So when you start up your business of stationery and bookshop, here are some of the important points that needs to be considered. The first important point is survey of the market. Survey of the market is the essential aspect before starting any business. Now, when you prepare a business plan, then also you carry out the survey of the market. And once you have decided to open up a new venture, then also you need to do some survey for collecting the data with respect to the interior design, type of furnitures that you require, electrical fittings, etc. The data collected from the survey needs to be analyzed and then final decision is to be taken. The furniture, the electrical fittings and fixtures that you wish to purchase for your shop will be finalized after you go through various options available in the market. Most of the work like furniture, electrical fitting, etc. will be taken care by the local carpenter and electrician. The local carpenter and electrician would be able to accomplish the work under your guidance. So, you need to survey the equipments you wish to purchase. Basically, in a stationery shop, there are racks, there are tables, there are front desk, chairs that you need to finalize. A detailed survey of the equipment, the cost survey, would help you to decide on selection of this equipment. The detailed survey of the equipment is a must before spending money. This step shall be taken care while preparing the business plan also. The next important point is startup investment. Depending upon the business plan, location, bill of material, running expenses, etc., the startup cost is worked out. You need to make sure that you work out future expenses like maintenance cost, running charges, facility overheads, etc. also. When you do the business, you have invested a lot of money into it. It is very important to carry out certain safety measures to ensure that there is no accident that happens. In order to protect your investment and stock from some unforeseen accidents, there are some important aspects that you need to take care. The first important safety aspect is the regular upkeep. Whenever you open the shop in the morning, you make sure that some dusting, some cleaning of the racks and the floor is done. The termite treatment of the shop is required. Otherwise, the termites will spoil the inventory of the stationery items and books. You should use the quality raw material, particularly electrical wires and fixtures, in order to avoid any electrical accident. Improper handling can also lead to injuries, wasted energy, and wasted time. Use of the wrong equipments and letting just anyone try to move and store the inventory material can lead to accident. Safety is an important aspect for the handling of the books and the stationery items. These safety aspects, if ignored, can pose serious risk to your business. To avoid these problems, the capability of workers should be assessed and then the work task should be assigned accordingly. The next important point that you need to take care of is the inventory or stock management. The stock management is very important in any retail business. You can use a stock register to start with. You should be cautious about overstocking and understocking. If the investment permits, you can go for a computer-based stock register also. The storage of the goods in racks or bookshelves is to be done properly with the help of identification tags, so that these can be easily located. Another important aspect is the operational aspect. The owner may recruit staff for running the shop, or he can do it himself. Most of the time, you will find that the owner himself owns and operates with a few locals or family members as assistant. He has direct rapport with the customers. He determines the retail strategy depending upon location and product mix. If you have hired staff members, then in such cases, proper instructions needs to be given to the co-workers. You can prepare a checklist that would be more helpful in such cases. This checklist would contain standard do's and don'ts which the co-worker needs to remember. The entrepreneur shall keep himself updated about the latest trends in the stationery and bookshop field. So in this presentation, we have given you some of the technical details and important points for stationery and bookshop business. Thank you.